How's it going, Bozo? Hope you're doing well today. I thought it was about time I just sat down and talked to you for a little while again. So, like always, I want you to get comfy and cozy in your chair or your bed or wherever it is that you are. Got a blanket here, as per usual, and I'm just gonna tuck you in, nice and tight, just tuck you, nice and tight, nice and tight, there you go, tuck you in there, and of course, please, can't do it for you, unfortunately. I'm just gonna chat to you for a little while. I've got a couple of things that I thought you might be interested to hear. And I feel like it's been a little minute since I've gotten to talk to you. So, without further ado, let me begin the yap fest for you. Also say there will probably be a lot of brushing in this one. I put the really soft and fluffy windshield on, and I have just a very bad habit now. Anytime I put this on, I just wanna play with it. It's so soft. Side. I want to try and make as few cuts as possible. So I hope you can bear through those and still relax and get to sleep. Do you ever just have one of those days? You just don't want to be there anymore. That was kind of the day that I had today. For those of you who don't know, I do work a full-time job. And as much as I really like my job, it can get pretty stressful, I guess would be the word. Kind of hectic as well. And so today we were just short-staffed. There wasn't enough people to do the work. There wasn't enough people to do the work that we needed done. And so I ended up having to pick up a lot of the slack. But it got me thinking, I rarely take holidays, and so I've accumulated a lot of time off, so I could take a break. Issue being, I've never actually been on a plane before. I've traveled around my own state me into different places here. But it was always by car that I traveled. So I was thinking, if I was to take a holiday, I think I would finally like to take a trip somewhere. Finally catch my first plane ride. Mod back when I would have been like 13 or 14, and he's now one of my closest friends actually. Last year actually, he flew over from one of the other states here, Queensland. He flew over and visited me and my friends here, because there's a group of us that all know him. And so he flew here and spent about a week with us. So I was thinking maybe I could, you know, do the inverse of that. Maybe me and my mates could go over there and see him. See what Queensland's like. Also, always wanted to go see Tasmania, which is, if you're not from Australia, you got the island of Australia, and then just down there is a little island. Well, not little, it's a quite big island. It's little compared to the island of Australia. Is funny to say, because Australia is a continent, a country, and an island all in one. But off the island of Australia, there's a small island called Tasmania, if you didn't know. And it's just absolutely beautiful there. In the middle of nowhere, Tasmania. I believe in like a hotel or something. So he was suggesting to me that we could all go over there and visit his brother and stay at the hotel that he works at. The only thing is that it would be in the middle of nowhere, so there probably wouldn't be many people. And seeing as me and my mates are all sort of gaming nerds, it might be a little different to what we're used to. I think we could do it. I don't think it'd be an issue, but we could definitely spend a week or two without internet. I know I could. There is a country I've always wanted to go to, and if it wasn't obvious from what you can just see around me, considering there's this here, there's these here, there's this row of books right there, there's this row of books here, there's a little something-something sitting up there, and even behind me, I think even more behind. Sort of originating from the same country, which is Japan. I'm a very big fan of all things Japanese culture. also love my anime and manga. But also, so, number one country I've always wanted to travel to, it's Japan. The thing is though, I never liked the idea of going there and not being able to speak the language. So one of the things that stopped me from going for the longest time. The language barrier. And when you tell that to people, and they're always like, if you stay in the touristy parts, if you stay in the touristy parts, like Tokyo or Kyoto or Osaka, you stay in all those parts and those cities, you'll be fine. They have English signs and a lot of people speak a little bit of English there. But I always felt that missed sort of the reason why I wanted to go there and learn Japanese. Learn Japanese to go there. I want to experience Japan as Japan, not as a tourist destination. I didn't want to go there and not be immersed in the culture. Been practicing my Japanese, and it's not terrible, but it's not good either. For those who don't know, I just said I do speak a little bit of Japanese, but I'm still not. So it might seem like I'm good, but trust me, that's like a sentence that I've thought about before. Because I was like, how do you tell someone you can speak Japanese but not oh, very well? And so that's sort of the way that I would have phrased it. If you speak more fluently than I, let me know if there's like a better way to say that. But yeah, so I'm still practicing my Japanese. I've sort of picked it back up again recently. I did drop off for a little while. I did drop off learning it for a little while. I just kind of neglected it. I don't know. Like I think I said this last time to you. I kind of just stopped doing a bunch of my hobbies. I don't know why, it wasn't like a particular reason. I just sort of kind of dropped them all. Dropped doing them for some reason. And I consider my, sorry, I hope you don't mind if I'm just gonna do some visually plucking and pulling while I talk to you. Japanese is something I consider a hobby, I guess. It's something that I do quite consistently. It takes up time and I enjoy doing it. So yeah, I consider that a hobby and I had dropped it, but I've picked it back up again. So, after learning and refreshing my brain, because it's kind of fascinating to me how quickly you can forget a language when you don't use it. I was getting really good at like sort of more complex sentences. And then I stopped. And because I wasn't learning it again when I went to pick it back up, I just couldn't remember. I couldn't remember most of what I was previously learning. So now I'm back to more basic sentences, and I can't. I was gonna say conjugate, I don't know if that's the right word. I can't craft more complex sentences like I used to about 6 months ago. Some tea here. And if you want some, I'm sorry, I didn't make you a cup. I sincerely apologize. It's still a bit warm. Oh. Actually, that's like perfect temperature. Sorry, I hope you're cozy in your bed and you don't mind. You don't mind if I saying to you, I got distracted. I distracted myself. Something about learning Japanese. Yeah. So, now that I've been picking up learning Japanese again. Into it. I was thinking maybe it's time. I took some time off work. I took a flight to Japan. Because there's definitely a couple of places that I want to go. I've always wanted to visit. Well, I mean, I think it's obvious. Who doesn't want to go see those stairs from and in the manga, or I guess the film as well, Koe no Katachi, a silent voice. Koe no Katachi. I think I just butchered that again. A silent voice. We'll say it in English so I don't have to make myself sound stupid. There's the bridge in a silent voice. And I just had to look up where it was, and that's, I really want to go visit there as well. I feel like that would be kind of neat, because it wouldn't be as popular as the stairs. Especially since the stairs are in Tokyo, and the bridge is, I'm not sure where, I think it's like in between Kyoto and Osaka. Or something. It's been a while since I've looked at a map and seen where it was. So those are like the two main like things that I would want to go and visit. But then other than that, there's also the shrines. Any of the Shinto shrines. There's no major one that I wanted to go do. But that, maybe go see the building that's still standing after the atomic bomb went off. feel like I just want to like walk just around, like, and just get lost in the country. Another reason why learning the language would be good, because I want to go there and like not have a plan, because I never like planning things, if that wasn't obvious. I just kind of like to go there and just walk around and see what I could find and be able to go into a shop. So I've been thinking about it. I've been thinking about taking some time off work. The only thing is, I no longer have just one commitment. I no longer have just one commitment. I do have this thing that I'm doing to you right now. The little chats that I have with you, and the times that I play around and make fun ASMR. Having a consistent schedule that I can do. And consistently post to. It actually annoys me when I think I'm behind. When I think I'm behind on schedule, I always rush to make a video. But also, if I took time off, some special content just for you. Maybe something a little more planned out. It looks like my camera is going to die. I didn't charge it. Bozo moment. Give me a minute. Something. I do have something that I want to say. However, I think I talk about it too much. Every time I talk to you, I think I've brought it up like every time, almost. Yeah, and that's Minecraft. I keep going back to it. I don't know why. I think I mentioned we had like a hardcore world, and then we stopped doing that. I don't remember if last time I did this, I talked about the Skyblock world that we're doing. match in the game, but you're given nothing. That's kind of what it is. I've been playing that with one of my friends. The one that I always play the game with. And I really want to like show off what we've done, because it's like the coolest looking skyblock. I've been playing Minecraft since almost its release. Has updated so much that there's now a way, the coolest thing, there's now a way to make dirt. Yes, I know, that sounds dumb, but think about it. In Minecraft, if you've ever played the game, there's always an infinite amount of dirt just everywhere around you, so you never had the need to make it. Skyblock map. You're given a specific amount, and that's all you ever get. And if you destroy it all as well, then you can never get grass blocks again. So you can have dirt, but you can't have grass, because you need grass to grow more grass. So it's like a you have to think about that stuff when you're playing that game. However, now you can trade two gravel and two dirt to make four coarse dirt, and then you can hoe the four coarse dirt and then mine it with a shovel, and now you have four regular dirt. Yes, very, very entertaining and interesting stuff I'm talking about. I know, very entertaining and interesting stuff. However, because now, instead of just having the, you would have a 3x3x3, so 3x3 is, what, 9, and then 9 times 3 is 36, is my math, no, my math is wrong, 27, right, 9, 18, 27, I don't know why I did, my math was wrong there, so 27, and then you have that times 3, take 1, so, 60, oh my god, I'm gonna do math, 14 plus 7 is a 21, what did I just say, 60 plus 21 is 81, take 1, 80, is the math right there? Oh, I'm gonna seem like such an idiot if the math is wrong. I think you have like 80 blocks of dirt to start off with, and that's all you ever got, and yeah, now you can get infinite just by doing that. So I'm able to make like forests and fields and like have areas for animals to spawn, and it's just so much fun. And especially like flying around the map with the elytra now. You can see elytra in the game. It's just like basically negates. It basically negates the skyblock, because you'd fall off and you'd fall into the void, but now you can just so it's very fun. But the I can make like so much more. I can make so much more pretty and beautiful looking things in it. I might actually, like, I don't know, maybe I'll put like a screenshot or something right there. That's what the world looks like from above. And I'm very proud of it, because most of the decorating was done by me, and most of the farms were made by my friend. So it's a very good combination, because he makes the resources and then I use the resources to make the place look nice. which is fun because base game Minecraft, I never like, I never know what I want to do. But for some reason, Skyblock this time, it's making it like so refreshing. I'm like thinking, I'm like, oh, I can put like a river here now and then have like it flow into like an underground tunnel, and I can, I'm the one that has to build all of it. It's not already there. Like I'm playing Minecraft back in 2012 again for the first time, and just discovering a world and then like molding it to what I have in my head. Not actually one to ever really celebrate Halloween. It's not really a thing here in Australia. Like, we do have some people who all go trick-or-treating, but most of the time, and from my experience, most people just like don't want anything to do with the holiday. Is coming up, and while I'm not really one to celebrate it or do anything for it really, I do have a friend who likes to throw parties for it, which will be nice because they invited my mate who had a kid recently, so I don't get to see him very often. He's looking after the baby, obviously. And I finally met the kid for the first time a little while ago now, a couple weeks back. And it was just the cutest thing ever. It really fulfilled like an itch that I had for like a new parenthood or something, just to finally like have a baby around. I don't know, it was like a fun. But yeah, so I'm gonna see him again soon for Halloween. I don't think things will ever be the same for our little friend group now that he's around. No more staying up until 3 a.m. playing Jackbox on the Switch, playing Quiplash, laughing so hard. that's not a bad thing, is it? Things have to pass to make way for new things. And so just because they have a kid now, I may not get to see him very often, but the times that I do are very special now. So I guess for once I am actually looking forward to Halloween. And whilst I won't dress up or, you know, put on a costume, not gonna put on a costume or dress up or do anything fancy, I'm gonna go there, I'm gonna maybe have a drink, maybe, we'll see. I don't like to drink very often, if I've not ever mentioned that before. I do drink, but I don't do it very often. So, you know, have a quiet little night with my friends, and then call it early and take a nice nap. That sounds like a pretty good Halloween to me. Don't want any of this going out to clubs and getting wasted. Why would I do that? I'd rather just have a nice quiet night. Go home and listen to a bit of ASMR. Said sort of the main things that I wanted to say to you today. I said the most important things that I've been thinking about. Hopefully that was enough to get you to fall asleep. If it wasn't, just take some time now to turn off your phone. Put your phone away. A simple task to distract your brain. I always find that's the best way to get ready to sleep. Getting rid of any distractions.